Hi everyone, Anna from Read365 here. Today I am doing a Read365 review of Jennifer Conweiler's The Genius of Opposites. So as many of you may know, I'll be speaking in November at the conference about introversion, about what it is and what it isn't, so clearing up a few of those myths that we have about it, looking at it in terms of student leadership, and how we can create opportunities that work for introverts and extroverts alike when getting students involved and shaping them into leaders. I've done a lot of reading on this topic over the past 5 years, and this is the first book that I've seen that talks specifically about creating partnerships between introverted leaders and extroverted leaders. So one of the things that I like a lot about this book is that there's a model that you'll see that goes through, and it shows each part of the development of that relationship. So accepting the alien, bringing on battles, recognizing that it's difficult, casting the character, figuring out who does what the best, destroying disagreements, finding times when there are disagreements or subjects that arise that you're not going to figure out, and recognizing that each person can't offer everything. And I love that she breaks down the book into 5 easy chunks like that. The other thing that I really like about this book is that Jennifer Conweiler's always been very good at showing what the strengths are for introverts and for extroverts alike, and she does that with each step of the model that she introduces. But she also talks about what happens when it goes too far in the opposite direction and how embracing these qualities can make things difficult. So she is very realistic about the possibility that some things that we might see as good, too much of them isn't a good thing either. She's read a lot of the same literature on introversion and extroversion that I have, books like Susan Cain's Quiet, but she also pulls from a number of other different types of sources. Another book that I enjoyed reading earlier this year was Joshua Wolfshank's Power of Two about creative partnerships, and you can tell she's read that as well. She even digs into historical books like Doris Kearns Goodwin's The Bully Pulpit, talking about the relationship between Teddy Roosevelt and William Howard Taft. And she fills her research not just with books about temperament, but also about relationships. And that's how you can tell she's done the research to find out what's working and what isn't. So, as you're moving forward, looking for a kind of offbeat leadership book to talk a little bit more about one element of the leadership development process, I strongly recommend you look at The Genius of Opposites by Jennifer Conweiler. This has been Anna for Read365. Thanks so much, and I will talk to you again soon.